good evening, everyone. Hi. I know it's a little warm in here, but I think we'll stick it through. I'm glad to see all of your faces on this evening. Glad that you guys came out to celebrate our girls, celebrate a wonderful pageant. For those that were there, did you guys enjoy it?
Yes.
Well, I always think it's very important to ensure that each person that's connected to the pageant, whether it be a volunteer or a sponsor or one of our girls or one of our moms, right, that they are properly thanked and that they are properly appreciated. So this event gives us that opportunity. So let me stick by the script. Good evening and thank you for joining us for the second annual GEAYA Miss Juneteenth Director's Awards, sponsored by One United Thing and empowered by Houston Tillotson University. We are glad that you've joined us for a time of celebration, recognition, and conversation.
This evening, for your listening pleasure, we would like to introduce an artist who has freshly began her musical journey. Through music, she hopes to inspire listeners to embark on their own personal journey and self-discovery. Tonight, she will be sharing works from her first album, which has the intent to release this fall, introducing Noella Gray.
Or where you feel like you are. It's almost a hard song to
Thank you.
Also, I would like to thank Samuel Luna for helping me with that. The next one is the title brief. I also wrote that, you know, with the uplifting spirit in mind.
Herself, and then the director is actually going to present her with a certificate of participation and then also a free ticket to the zoo, sponsored by the Austin Zoo.
Thank you.
this year's Miss Juneteenth pageant will receive a $7,000 scholarship. We would like to have our Miss Juneteenth, Ebony Henderson, to please come up to the stage to receive that.
Likewise, many gifts and donations came from various community groups in These include the NAACP, Travis County Republican Party, the Heritage Box, Bright Financials, Keller Williams Realty, New York Life Insurance Company, Alibi X.
I think we can probably hold our applause until the end of the year.
All right.
It's a little hot.
Global Austin, Impact Outreach, Capoletta, Massage Envy, Steiner Ranch, and the Hair Lounge.
Yeah. And there's also a few more. The Austin Zoo, and you guys can hold your applause. Vernon's Vibrational Massage, and there are some 1 hour long massage tickets up there to be bidded on. Damza Center for the Arts, great group of people. They are providing our Little Miss Juneteenth with a camp, with the ability to go to camp this summer. Cap City Crochet, there's also an auction item up there with them. Strawberry Queen, Kat Carter, Ms. Sharon Armstrong. And I'd also like to bring up to the stage really quick here, the Gabrielle Neela campaign. What a big sponsor. She has been to every event that we've had so far, and I just want to say he's definitely been a person of in great standing with the Miss Juneteenth Scholarship Pageant. So please come on up. A few more that I cannot neglect, but say their name. So, Premier Designs, Mariposa, The Rolling Rooster. The National Society of Black Engineers, Austin Caribbean Cultural Exchange, Photography and Media by Cindy Elizabeth, Tiffany Nicole Loves, Lakeem Natural Born Star. We had just several wonderful people coming on board for this pageant, and I just want to thank each and every one of you for doing so. Today, our queens walk away with several gifts from many of these sponsors. Audience, please give them a big round of applause for contributing to this. All right, at this time, we are going to break for just about 10 minutes. I'm going to allow you guys to go and get cookies, and we're going to get ready for our panel discussion. That's pretty much one of the main reasons why we came here today, is so that we can actually hear from the girls. So they are going to sit down, and they're going to talk and tell you about what happened at the pageant and what they've learned. Please, cookies and drinks are at the top of the area. There's also an auction table. Please, this is the auction table. Okay, there's a few other people. Now you can hear me, huh? Hello, good morning. Merry Christmas. All right. There's a few other people that I want to make sure that we recognize before we get started. And then we also want to hear from the Greater East Austin Youth Association's founder, Mr. Cannon. So the first person that I want to call up here, and we actually do have someone that's going to represent their group, is the Travis County Republican organization. And Mr. Gabriel Amelia, would you mind coming down to accept that award? Right now with me. This phenomenal photographer came on board, and she is the official photographer of Little Miss Juneteenth and Little Miss Mini Juneteenth, Carlita Hill. Would you please come on up? Wesley Shinault, if you don't mind coming on up and receiving the award. He has put together a wonderful presentation for us, and I believe we are going to see it here soon. Volunteers that I do want to recognize before we leave this space. And also, well, before I say that the volunteers, I want to personally thank Jonathan Davis. Thank you for coming on board so this Juneteenth pageant. He gave us a sponsorship in order to have refreshments today. So big thank you. Some of the volunteers that came on board, I call them volunteers, but these girls would probably call them mentors, right? Yes, we had some wonderful mentors that helped us out throughout this entire pageant. One of those mentors, I would like to, and I know you just got comfy, Miss Ashley Blash Gordon, would you please come on up to the front? I'm going to just have all of our mentors come up. I also want to bring to the front Mrs. Nancy Durbin. There you are. Hi. Woo! Wonderful. I'd also like to bring up Mr. Dilbert Crawford. And one of our judges are here today, Mrs. Winnie. Would you mind coming up to the front? And I would like to bring up one of our volunteer extraordinaires, the Miss Olivia Green. Please come to the front. The Miss Olivia Green is also going to be receiving our Honorary Queen Award for the evening.
Closer.
Aisha, please come on up here too. We are all volunteers. We're going to go ahead and hand out a couple of gift bags for our winners, and we're going to start off with our princesses. Yay! Little Miss Mini Princess Zayla, please come to the front. Line these ones up. One second. is she receiving a scholarship from Houston Tillotson University, but she's also receiving a scholarship from Greater East Austin Youth Association. And inside of that bag are some wonderful gifts. One of the gifts are coming from Africa Designer. So you're getting a designer, one-of-a-kind dress. lots of things from the Caribbean Exchange. Please come up and just get these gifts. Our Miss Juneteenth Queen 2016, happy anniversary. Put her stuff away, and also accept a couple of couple more of zoo passes. Okay, these are for you guys. Yes, ma'am.
With our conversation for tonight, we have our junior Miss Juneteenth, Miss Queen, Corinne Oliver, and we have our Miss Juneteenth Queen, Ebony Henderson.
Families and businesses moved out of the historic East Austin, leaving many hollow ground due to gentrification. Many vibrant and cultural rich historic businesses have been torn down due to investors not recognizing their value. My goal is to create an app that will highlight the remaining businesses in East Austin and restore value to the community almost lost. Encouraging Austinites and those visiting Austin to patronize establishments like the Victor Grill, the Carver Museum, and Cultural Center, Ideal Soul Mart, Black Butterfly, and many, many more.
My platform was arts education. Lots of schools here in Austin and all over the country don't have a great arts program, and I like to bring that to young people and the old. It's never too late to get the arts in your life. Even studies have shown that arts, people who are in band and in theater, they get better grades and they have better futures. Tonight's discussion will cover what it means to be born royal and how stereotypes affect us, the youth, and what we've learned as contestants going through this pageant. Each contestant has been assigned one question and will be the first to answer it.
Please allow me to introduce the panel for this evening. Miss Juneteenth Princess Maya Smith. Maya Smith, daughter of Jared and Stacy, is an advocate for all and a social activist in her own right. She has a twin sister named Jordan, who is both her best friend and support. She loves traveling too. Just last Christmas, she was blessed with the opportunity to go to Spain, Germany, and France. Last summer, she went to Washington, D.C., as she had the pleasure to speak with 14 senators and representatives from different states. Maya is always looking for a way to get involved, whether it's with Girl Scouts or FCCLA. For the third year in a row, Maya was awarded the Presidential Gold Award for committing to over 300 hours of community service. In college, Maya Smith plans to study communications because she believes it's crucial to know how verbal and nonverbal messages are affecting Black youth. Yes.
Next, we have our little Miss Juneteenth Queen 2016, Nyla Kelly. Nyla Kelly is a 10-year-old from Del Valle, Texas. She's an active member in the National Elementary Honor Society and Student Council at Pope Ham Elementary. She participated in the beautification project at her school by picking up litter, clearing out weeds, and bringing life to plants that were hidden in the school courtyard. Nyla has a very creative mind and embraces life's challenges and blessings. She expresses herself through writing poetry and short stories. You will always find Nyla working on DIY projects that include origami, fashion, baking pastries, or making YouTube videos, to name a few. Turn on some music and you'll see the praise dancer from Macedonia Missionary Baptist Church twirling for the Lord. Nyla loves caring for others and plans to receive a doctoral degree in kinesiology, exercise, nutrition, health performance at Baylor University.
Next, we have our youth volunteer at the pageant, Nyla Carr. Nyla Carr is a 13-year-old AV Honor Roll student at Vista Classical Academy. She's an eager volleyball player who has loved sports since the first grade. Academically, Nyla has ranked high in her classes since kindergarten, where she was the only kindergartner to receive the Dean's Academic Award at Victory Christian Academy. In addition to challenging herself mentally and physically, Nyla's other interests include fashion design, sewing, crafting, dance, and filmmaking. Having completed 6 short film projects with the Austin Film Society, being a social butterfly, Nyla also expresses her social consciousness by volunteering in the following areas: wrapping gifts for Project Blue Santa, production and on-air work at KIVI, FM 88.7, feeding the homeless, through the Soul Movement Church, and teaching sign language to younger kids at the Promised Land Explorer Summer Program.
Our Miss Juneteenth hostess, 2015-2016, Jaleesa Stiles. Jaleesa is a 16-year-old senior at Henderson High School. She has hosted the Miss Juneteenth pageant for a second time this year and hopes to continue to serve as long as possible. Jaleesa is a lover of the Lord, a volunteer for many different organizations, to include the Pageant, the Awesome Activist Leaders Camp, and more. She's an organizer at her school for the Black Empowerment Activities, and just recently worked to restore the Colored Cemetery in Pflugerville, Texas. She hopes to graduate next year and go to an HBCU. She is your 2016 Ideal Miss Princess.
Last but not least, we have our Junior Miss Juneteenth Princess, India Hicks. India Hicks, age 11, 11 years old, from Houston, Texas, relocated to Austin area in the summer of 2013, attends Texas Empowerment Academy, where she serves as the PLC leader, mentoring and tutoring her peers. She is actively involved in the youth ministry as a praise dancer and youth choir member for St. James Missionary Baptist Church in Austin. India is the second of four children. She enjoys singing, dancing, hanging out with friends and family. She enjoys reading. India seeks to accomplish her dreams and goals, owning her own literacy program for kids as a teen, being promoted to high school, graduating high school, attending college, and continuing her literacy program, along with owning one other business venture, as well as becoming a certified teacher.
Our first question is from Ms. Nyla Kelly. Queen Nyla, in the pageant you brought back to life Queen Ya Ashantua. Would you perform the monologue again and then tell us how your queen's strength made you strong today?
I am Queen Ya Ashantua of the Agueso tribe of the Ashanti in modern Ghana. We were under the British protection when they demanded our golden stool, a symbol of our independence. The Ya Ashantua War for Independence began on March 28, 1900. The British captured me, and until my death, I remained in exile.
Now, how does she make you strong today?
Well, what I have learned from her is it doesn't matter what gender or race you are, you can do anything you put your mind to.
Thank you, Ms. Nyla Kelly.
So, do any of the girls have an opinion or a feeling about how the queens make you strong today? Esther, and I felt like she was a queen that exuded grace and class, and she was also confident and fearless because she had to go outside of her comfort zone and do things that weren't necessarily something that she wanted to do or something that she felt like she could, but she followed God and what he had for her, and she was amazing, and she actually impacted the life of her people.
I had Deborah, she could be found in Judges 5 and 7 in the Bible, and she taught me that as long as you stick with God, he will get you through it. This battle was happening, and she didn't know how she was going to get through it. She was asking Barak, he wasn't doing anything, but he stuck with her. God stuck on her side, and in the end, she became a mother in Israel, and that means the world to everyone in Israel. So that was what she has taught me.
This question is for Jaleesa Stiles. For the last 2 years, you have served as a mentor for the pageant. Why is community service so important to you today?
No, I play to go to college one day, so I need to listen. No, I'm just kidding. But community service to me has, I guess, become more familiar through this past year and last year, helping out with the Juneteenth pageant and other activities that my mom kind of brings me into. I think that it's important today and important for younger kids to really be a part of because we definitely are a face for a certain group of people, and we are a face for young Black people too, and to see that we are involved in certain things in our community to help make our community a better place for us to live in and grow up in, I think that we should be as involved as we can. So, yeah, that's how I feel about community service.
Would any of the other girls like to speak about community service?
Being that community service is something that comes naturally to me. I'm
constantly putting myself in situations where it's going to count as community service. Like Jaleesa said, we are a base for this certain community that has such a negative connotation after all of these years. We need to be as involved as we can. We aren't what they say we are. We have a certain type of way of carrying ourselves that they haven't realized yet. We were born royal, sorry, we were. So that's one of the ways we can embrace that is by giving back to our community.
Born royal. It's Maya Smith, everybody, just let you know. What makes you born royal?
Okay, I prepared this question in my head. So when I was thinking about the things that, well, first of all, what even born royal means, one of the textbook definitions of born royal is having the natural ability to do something in a specific area. And royalty's synonyms include excellent, superb, fine. I'm not trying to sound conceited, but in some areas I do have that natural ability to be excellent. I have that natural ability to be superb in whatever way I want to. And I carry myself with great pride that I will do something excellent.
Say that, baby.
That was a great answer. Would anybody else have to chime in on what makes you born royal?
So, me specifically, I feel like being born royal is something that just comes from how you carry yourself, how you believe in yourself, how you don't let anyone stop you, how you hold your head high, and how you know that your lineage and who you are as a person is great. And I feel like every one of us is royal, and it's just naturally royal because we are who we are, and because God is our Father and He's the King, and so that all means we're all royal. So that's not true.
To me, what born royal means is to be treated with respect. Because if you are treated with respect, then no one will ever know you exist. No one will treat you like you should actually be treated.
How should parents cultivate royalty in their daughters?
I think that parents should teach their daughters to be confident and teach their daughters to surround themselves with people who have like the same set of goals or just people who think that people like them who are similar to them.
How should parents cultivate royalty in their daughters?
Okay. Well, I think that I kind of have to go with Nyla on this one. I think that parents, mothers, and fathers should, you know, treat their daughters like royalty. And I think that I can thank my parents for that, especially. I've grown up not cocky, not like that or anything, but feeling very independent, maintaining propriety, and maintaining that confidence level that you need to understand that people do have a higher respect for you when you have those traits in a girl. So, yeah.
For me, my mom has always said, Ebony, you're a princess. She calls me her little princess since I was young. She told me to carry myself high and show that I am better, or not better, but just as good as anyone, and knowing that I was capable, she's always kind of pushed me to always work harder because I am royal and I deserve to to be the best. And so my mom has always just pushed me, just giving me the extra nudge to say, okay, you don't have to do what everybody else is. You can be greater, you can do more, you can take the harder classes, you can do better. do it.
For me, I think you need to set a foundation first and go to church. Knowing that God is my father makes me know that my parents care and they know that I'm royalty. And knowing that I have him and my parents on my side, that's like a double whammy there. I just won the lottery. It's awesome. A great answer, everybody. Our last question is for India Hicks. Why is it important to be a strong Black woman in society today?
Well, in my opinion, it is important because people see us as, when they see Black women as caregivers, maids, cookers, they don't see us as leaders like Dr. Martin Luther King or Rosa Parks. They see us as, hey, all she gotta do is cook for my kids and that's good. They don't see us as, you can go be a doctor, you can go be a lawyer, you can go make money. They don't see us as that. They see us as homeless people that just need to help their kids, help them. They live off of Black women. They don't live off of who they really are. They only live off of them because they're Black. So in my opinion, that is why it's important to be a Black woman. A strong Black woman in today's society.
Would any other queen like to chime in? Why is it important to be a strong Black woman in society today?
Okay. I see the way I grew up, all I see is strong Black women. That's all I see. So when I'm just getting all this information fed to me about, all you gotta do is stay on the streets. All you gotta do is sell drugs to get by. I'm like, I'm going to college. What are you doing, you know? And so they have to know that we have a voice and that we're gonna be doing something great, you know? So in order to get there, it starts with what Nyla said, having that confidence, so.
Thank you for your answer.
Thank you for taking the time to support the Miss Juneteenth pageant conversation. As we end this evening, please allow me to bring up the chairwoman, Ms. Mimi Stiles, once again.
Didn't they do wonderful? So there are a few people in here that serve on panels. I'm one of them. And this right here, I think this was a great start. Wouldn't you guys say?
Yeah.
We hope for many more of these. This was our nice mini conversation. Before I take my seat here too, and what I'd like to do is first bring back up my right hand, Ms. Tanisha Barnett, the director of the Miss Juneteenth pageant. And together, we would like to bring up Mr. Cannon, Greater East Austin Youth Association, the first Black owned 501c nonprofit here in Austin, still existing.
First of all, good evening.
Good evening.
I'd like to just say first thanks to everyone that played a part in this event. Everyone. I'm talking about the parents, the kids, the volunteers, everyone that played any part in making this event successful. I'd like to say this event was second to none. Not only did I enjoy the pageant I thought it was a great fair. Those of you who may not have gotten a chance to attend it, you really missed a great event. And I'm quite sure that Mimi, with the direction, we want you to know, of course, you did a great job. And you know, we have our award ceremony later. I'm sitting in for our Juneteenth chairperson tonight, Ms. Tammy. I'm the one that always get put on the spot. But I'm only one third of the founder of Greater East Austin Youth Association. Mr. James Howard, Mr. George Thomas is the other two thirds of the organization. Greater East Austin Youth Association is, of course, 501c3. Donations are accepted. They are tax deductible. They are. So we want you to know that. Also, Greater East Austin Youth Association is 100% nonprofit. And I'd like to say that everywhere I go, I try to inform people. Greater East Austin Youth Association is over 40 years old, one of the oldest existing organizations in Austin and recognized by the city of Austin. Very well. We're not a fly-by-night. We've been here, and we've done that for years. Actually, we are proud to say youth is our business. That's the business we have, the youth. That's what we came into existence in order to bring out the best in youth in something that God gave them, which was athletic ability. That's where we started. Then we moved on into the Juneteenth, when the city allowed us to use Juneteenth as a fundraiser, not only as historical, but the funds that's raised through Juneteenth, it goes into the organization to help youth in our community. Because a lot of kids in our community was unable to participate in sports and anything back in the days because the parents couldn't afford to pay for it. And that's why we came into existence. Because if you all would think about something, I believe it was John F. Kennedy said, he said, ask not what you can do for your country, ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country. Give back. This is something that some of the young people here said today. They're going to be giving back in the community because they realize what makes us raw is being a part of that village, is helping others. Thank y'all so much. Thank you. We need all the people that are speaking. We're proud of her. She's done a great job. We appreciate her husband. I see him up there. We appreciate him letting her, or being a part of letting her, do what she do for these young people. And Great East Austin do not take it lightly. Thank y'all.
Very quickly, I'd like to have Mrs. Alexandra Wilson come to the front. She was our phenomenal PR. She came in late, but I make sure that I recognize everyone that comes into this space. And also Ms. Thea with Shabante Clothing. She came on board to help out dress our host and our hostess. Would you mind coming up front, please?
Sharing your daughters with us, because all of these girls are like phenomenal. When you get to know each one individually and see what is special about them, you're like, you really have to thank the parents. So I want to thank you guys for allowing your children to actually participate with us and sharing them with us. to the sponsors, to the volunteers, to all of the supporters, to Greater East Austin. We appreciate everything that you guys do for us and with us, and we can't thank you enough. Although we may have given out a very small token of our gratitude and our appreciation, we just want you to know that it's extremely, extremely remembered, and it's really appreciated. So from Tanisha and Mimi, we thank you. And from all of us up here, thank you for coming and giving us an opportunity to share our girls, your girls as well too, and coming out tonight.
With that, we're going to end the evening. Again, if you have not had a chance to go by the auction table will be open for another 10 or 15 minutes. And also, if you did not get to go to the pageant, or if you did go to the pageant and you want to keep that memory, Wesley Shinault, one of our wonderful videographers, has put together a full program of the pageant, and it's very professional. You will have an opportunity to download that link. Information will be sent to you. The next event that our girls will be at, that you will see, is they will be meeting with the First Lady, Mrs. Abbott, on the 30th. So you will see our girls out in that space. And also tomorrow, I hope to see you all at Dr. Claude Anderson's event in the Bell County Expo. So the Black Business Expo, let me know if you want any information about that. Just a little plug. Have a great night.